Cure of the Centurion Servant, Matthew chapter 8, verses 5 to 13. As we read, we want to pay particular attention to certain words. When Jesus went into Capernaum, a centurion came and pleaded with him. "Sir," he said, "my servant is lying at home paralyzed and in great pain." So the centurion is making supplication for his servant. And here Jesus' response. Jesus said to him, "I will come myself and cure him." So whenever we speak to Jesus, he's always telling us, "I will come myself and do it. I myself will do it." He gives us that personal, undivided care and attention we need. The centurion replied, "Sir, I am not worthy to have you under my roof. Just give the word and my servant shall be healed." Those of us who are Catholics and we go to communion, the priest raises the host and we say, "Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But say the word." What is this word? Give that permission, give that healing, give me that permission to receive you. Well, at communion time, say the word and my servant shall be healed. "Sir, for I am under authority." So the man is saying this based on his own experiences. And Jesus heard this, he was astonished and said to all those who followed him, "In truth, I tell you, in no one in Israel have I found faith as great as this." So we are making that petition. We are exercising great faith. And great faith comes in all forms and fashion. Jesus says, "I will come and do it myself." And then the centurion says, "Lord, I'm not worthy for you to come into my house. My life is ugly. My life is miserable. Although my life is in a state, I do a lot of wrong things, I believe that you can heal from far." Today, more than ever, we have to believe that Jesus is way up in the heavens. Of course, our faith informs us that he is among us. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And at the same time, we are saying, "Jesus, you are far. Jesus, you are near, and simultaneously you are far. Come and heal. Come and touch. Come and transform." And when we exercise that deep faith, Jesus would always listen to us, because he tells us in verse 7, "I will come myself and cure him." We invite Jesus into our lives and say, "Jesus, come and cure me. Come and heal me. Most of all, Jesus, come and lay your hand upon me and give me your blessing." In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.